I don't understand what happened. Today I'm going to windproof this the garden shed and install the glass on the part between the greenhouse and the garden shed. So I didn't want to do it before the bars were installed in case something fell through, but now it's probably safe enough that I can do it. Will be handy. So I'm cheating and using silicone to glue my glass on the frame. I would normally have used putty, but it's functional and it's a lot easier to install it. So I'll do that. And also it means I won't need to repaint over the putty and the tape the glass and everything, so it's it will save me a lot of time. Yeah, if you can just put a little piece of tape at the back between the frame and the glass so it doesn't fall.
Not right now.
I need to put the glass first. So hold your horse. Just a bit rounded, which means it doesn't fit. Margot, could you pass me the pliers, please? Thank you. And I'm gonna try to chip. Here we go. Maybe a bit around here. Just to keep it pressed against the silicone. Yeah, let's put some.
That one's not very sticky anymore.
Let's hope the other ones fit a bit better. So next one. Attention. Okay, so this one's. That's weird. I had measured with a 1 centimeter leeway. I had made sure it was all a bit wider. Yet it's too big. I don't understand what happened. The frame is a bit irregular, so I've managed to fit 2 panes of glass, but the other 3 are just slightly too big, and I'm really bad at cutting glass, so I'd rather have it cut by somebody who knows what they're doing rather than trying to do a bad job myself and break everything. Went to the shop and got more fittings for my pipe work. I've slightly changed my mind about the design because I thought if I put it where the water comes at the top and have all the valves there, it won't be very easy to use on an everyday basis. So instead, I'm going to put them in a more central place on the wall where it's directly accessible from the floor. And I don't have to climb on a stepladder to change the watering of the garden. So my plan is I'm going to put it somewhere around here and have all the pipes visible from visible straight away. I sourced a float valve from a local reseller. So this is what I'm going to install inside the cistern. So there's basically the water arrives here from the spring, and once the tank is full, this floats and closes the valve. It's like for a toilet, basically, just a bit bigger. So I'm going to install it where at the side of the cistern here. So I'm going to drill in the cap so I don't have to drill the cistern itself, just in case I want to change my setup later on. See how it works. I have a little issue with this cap. The valve needs to go flush against the flat surface. And here there's a little reinforcement at the back of the cap, which means that it can't be completely flush. So what I'm going to do is grind excess plastic on this side and try to make it as flat as I can. First, I'm going to drill my hole where I need it to be. Valve will go like this. And I'm just going to get to grind this bit of plastic here. Sounds like an angry cat. It fits. I just need to tighten it. Okay, I think that's nice and tight. To put it from the outside. And that's all piped. Now I'll have to do another hole for the pump, but I need a flexible pipe for that, for a suction pipe that they didn't have at the shop. The outside of the cistern is connected, so literally all I need to do to be able to fill it up is to connect this pipe here that brings mains water or spring water to this pipe which goes towards the cistern. As I'd like to do a clean job and have all my distributors nicely laid against this wall, I would like to plaster it first, but it's still really damp because it's been raining outside, and so I can't do it right now. But there's another job I need to get to move on with because it's the spring, everything is growing like crazy. It's something very exciting that's happening outdoors. In the autumn, we planted some table grapevines along the wall of the vegetable garden in front of the chateau. And we showed all the process of planting these on Patreon. And there are all the different table grapes that we selected for because they were interesting historically, because they had something special about their fruit or their foliage, a particular taste that's quite unusual, an unusual origin or something. Basically, we wanted vines that you wouldn't be able to find anywhere else. A couple of days ago, I received another parcel from a plant nursery in Italy with another collection of quite rare table grapes that I'm going to plant on the other wall of the garden. And my idea on each wall is to have these vines climbing over the top and to train them so that we have like a railing of vine in the summer. Little while ago, I dug out the along the wall with the digger to make the soil a bit loose and get rid of the stones. It's been so rainy that I haven't been able to do much more. I'm just thinking I'm going to rotavate it just once more, so all the weeds get buried and it gives a better start to the vines. A nice collection of about 20 new varieties, table grapes, and plus 20 that I planted in the autumn on the other side of the garden. So that's going to be a really nice sampling of grapes from all around the world. What I do as in order to be able to manage the collection is that I sort them by alphabetical order along the wall, so that if one of the labels gets lost, I can manage to find the variety from the names in my records and my order. So it makes it a bit easier to track what was lost. Oh, I need to make sure they don't dry, so I'll keep them on the ground for the moment. Roll in order. Now I'm going to put a little bit of soil over the roots so they don't dry out, and I'll prepare the holes to plant them all. top part of the wall was a bit overgrown, so I had to come with the digger and scrape along it. There were old piles of stones and also an old stump that I had to remove. So luckily it was completely rotten, so I could do it without pulling the wall apart, luckily. So now it's this bit is also ready to plant, so I'm going to be able to come down and do this bit. This bit here is work in progress because it's the position where we are going to put the other greenhouse. So we have a second greenhouse that you might have seen on previous videos or Instagram, which is more beautiful than the one we installed on the other side. This one will be purely ornamental. It has a beautiful gallery at the top to put the blinds. It has a wrought iron staircase to climb onto the gallery, and it will be leaned against this this wall. So we are going to build a wall to install it right here. So at the moment I'm not planting too many things close by, because we'll be doing some work and we'll probably have to pull it away in order to finish that. So keep posted for this work, which will be extremely exciting. When we first arrived on in the chateau, all this plot was planted with very tall Douglas fir that were about 20 meters tall. So they were taller than the linden tree behind me. So there was absolutely no light here. It was completely shaded. And also we didn't have any view on the mountain on to the other side. So that's actually one of the first things we did, was to cut these trees, because they weren't very ornamental. They were planted as commercial timber in the 60s or 70s even. And it was just making everything really dark and making a lot of shade over the vegetable garden and the terraces. All done, thank you, Margot.
Anytime.
Oh, now you say?
Shoot, that's open-ended. I'm excited for them to grow.
Yep, so am I.
How many varieties do you have now?
About 40 different, I think.
Wow, table grapes. So,
yeah.
Wow.
And a few wine grapes too. Thank you everybody for watching. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe if you haven't done it yet. And see you next week.